I am Marcel Beugelstijf from the Netherlands. In this video, I will illustrate how to create a function in Power Query. As an example, I will use the ISO week numbering. The steps to create and use a function in Power Query are: first define parameters, then create a query, then create a function from that query, and then invoke the function. And the rules for ISO week number are over here. I won't explain the details, but you can pause the video and read them if you like to. Let's go to an empty file in Power BI. First step to do is to create a parameter, a new parameter. Now what we are going to use as a parameter is a date. So I will call this a date parameter. This is a required parameter, type date, any value, and the current value is 21st of January 2017, the date of recording. Second step is create query, source blank query, determine the date of Thursday of the current week. So we take the date from the parameter and we add 3 minus the day of the week of the parameter with Monday as first day of the week. Let's call this one Thursday. And next step is determine January 1st of the date from step 1. So January 1st is January 1st. The next step is to calculate the number of days from January 1st to the date from step 1. Days is, so this is the number of days. And the last step is divide the number of days from step 3 by 7, round down and add 1. Result is, okay, let's call this query ISO week number, and we're done with this query. What we have is a parameter and a query. Create a function from the query. To do that, we right click in the query and choose create function. Let's call it ISO week number. Okay, if you want to edit this function, it will state that this query is automatically updated whenever the example query is updated. So if you want to make any changes, you should do it in this query and not in the function itself. And now we will create a query to use that function. So we go to new source, and I have an Excel file with examples, a date table. In this table we have dates. The ISO week in the second column is the week number calculated using the Excel function ISO week number, and the other steps are exactly the step as we defined in our function. Now, in order to use our function, we can choose invoke custom function on the add column tab. Let's call this one Power Query ISO week function query. We use ISO week number function, and the parameter is one of the fields from this file, so that will be the date. Okay. Now we can add another column to check if the values are equal. So check results is ISO week from Excel is the same as ISO week from Power Query. And if we filter, we see there's only truths. So the outcome is correct. Last step may be to adjust the data type is the whole number. So again, first we defined our parameter. Then we created a sample query in which the ISO week number is calculated. Then we turned this query into a function using create function. And then in this query, we used invoke custom function to invoke our ISO week number function. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.